Merry Christmas, you hosers. It's been a long time. I hope you've been well. Me? Yeah, I'm doing all right. Thanks for asking. That's so sweet of you. We're approaching one of my two favorite holidays, so I've decided to make a deck about it while treating you to the music stylings of the legendary Scott Haig. And what better commander for a Christmas deck than one who gives gifts? Zedru the Greathearted. Santa Antelope. Santalope. Yeah, that's what we're going with. Santalope costs 1 generic, 1 red, 1 white, and 1 blue mana to cast, has a 2/4 body, and an ability that reads, at the beginning of your upkeep, you gain X life and draw X cards where X is the number of permanents you own that your opponents control. A nice benefit for giving presents to all the good boys and girls. But the thing that makes Zedru our Santa is its ability to give gifts with its final ability. Pay a red and white and a blue mana. Target opponent gains control of target permanent you control. This deck is going to make us ask the important questions. Like, if Santa is an antelope in this world, what are the reindeer? This deck isn't going to be a bad gifts deck. That's right, there's no coal in here. Nor will it be a chaos deck. It's not a combo deck either. Instead, this is going to be a deck that straddles the line between group hug and group slug. I've filled this deck with all kinds of nice little toys to hand out to all the good boys and girls at the table. As a definition, a good person is a highly aggressive opponent who attacks our opponents using what we give them, and they don't attack us. Bad people are people who play creatureless decks, pacifists, and opponents who attack us with our own gifts. We don't reward them with presents. We are also going to help our opponents act good by setting up some defenses so that we're harder to attack, and we'll protect Zedru as hard as we can. Before moving on, there is a rule that I think is vitally important to make you aware of when it comes to Zedru. When you give something to someone with Zedru, they gain control of it through Zedru's effect. When that player dies, the effect for them ends, and the permanent you gave them stays in play but returns to your control. It does not get exiled. This is a common misplay with Zedru, so I thought I'd better mention it. This also means you can freely spread your gifts around without fear of them going away forever. I ran into this rule a while back with my playgroup, and we had to consult a judge about it because nobody would believe me. To be fair, they were going to die if I was right, so I don't really blame them for wanting a judge's ruling. So, if this deck sounds interesting to you, watch on, my friend, and we'll get into the meat of the deck. But first, I did want to mention that this deck was built with an eye toward budget. As of the day I'm writing this script, the cost, if you're buying it from TCG Player, is $82.67, minus basic lands. TCG Player is the least expensive way I've ever found for buying cards, which may be relevant to you this holiday season, but I still recommend you go to your local game store first and get what you can there. Whatever you can't find, I've got a link for in my video description. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button. Doing that helps make sure YouTube recommends the video to others so they can get in on the Santalope fun too. Now then, we're going to start at the beginning, because stories that don't are stupid. Well, except for Memento, that movie's awesome. Wow, this is the first section and I'm already off track. Lands, guys. We're putting down land cards before we can cast any spells. These lands, coming from our hands, are going to be the utility lands. Access Tunnel, Rogue's Passage, Arcane Lighthouse, Contested War Zone, Scavenger Grounds, and Ghost's Quarter. Our deck isn't mana hungry, but Zedru certainly is color hungry, so we've got a lot of color fixing. The land portion of fixing comes from Command Tower, Exotic Orchard, and the Tricolored, Mystic Monastery and Rogren Triome, and we also have the Thriving Lands, Thriving Bluff, Heath, and Isle. Our basic lands are going to be 8 Mountains, 8 Plains, and 8 Islands. I mentioned that Zedru is color hungry, and I meant it. Because of this, we're running the color-fixing ramp spells, Arcane Signet, Felwar Stone, Ornithopter of Paradise, Azorius Signet, Boros Signet, Izzet Signet, Commander's Sphere, Rogren Crystal, and the land-ramping Burnished Heart. Our final card in this section isn't a ramp spell, but is a card that does find a land for us, and that's Expedition Map. You can use this to find a color you don't have, or you can find whatever utility land you need at a moment's notice. Once we're done with ramp, the first thing we want to do is set up our defenses. I mean, you can give someone a gift first, but just make sure they give their word not to attack you for a turn or two. Then set up your defenses. Ours are going to be Island Sanctuary, Orzhov Advocate, Web of Inertia, Energy Field, Solitary Confinement, and the card drawing Ever Watching Threshold, Search the Premises, and Farsight Mask. My favorite here is Solitary Confinement, because it's a pet card that I've never had the fortune to cast, and it basically makes you invincible. The downside of having to discard and having to skip your draw step is largely negated by us playing Zedru. As long as you've given away two gifts and have Zedru in play, you can keep this card on the battlefield indefinitely. Doing so will fill your graveyard up and keep you from being hurt. Before I forget to mention it, I've also got Disarm in this section. It's certainly not a conventional defense card, but if someone pays just all of the mana to equip their creature with your gifts, and then has the gall to attack you with it, well, this is a funny response. Humans are jealous creatures, and when they see Santalope giving gifts to the good boys and girls, they're going to act like the bad boys and girls that they are and try to kill her. We're going to offer Zedru some protection though, in the form of the Indestructible Bestowing, Blacksmith's Skill, Dauntless Bodyguard, and Boros Charm, and the Hexproof granting Dive Down, Mizium Skin, Giant's Amulet, and Curator's Ward. I chose to go with Hexproof here instead of Shroud because I wanted to be able to target Zedru for reasons. There's no point in making a Christmas deck if there's no gifts to hand out, so I've made sure to stick a bunch of them in Zedru's pack. At 1 mana, we have Bone Splitter, Colossus Hammer, Golem Skin Gauntlets, a Great Axe for European flair, and Onaginata for Japanese flair. Yes, I know, one of those is a continent and the other is a country, don't worry about it. At 2 mana, we have Ogre's Cleaver, Barbed Battle Gear, Bearded Axe, Dwarven Hammer, Four Bears Blade, even though we don't have any bears, Loxodon Hammer, and Sunforger, which we might just keep for ourselves. The highest mana costed equipment we have is the 6 mana Meteoric Mace, which will cascade for us before we give it away. I've put an eye toward Trample here in order to give evasion, and toward buffing creatures' power. Finally, I added 3 cards which aren't so much toys as they are toy amplifiers. These are Crown of Doom, Furnace of Wrath, and Dictate of the Twin Gods. The Crown is less effective, but gives itself away, and the other two are just super effective. In spite of its higher mana cost, I actually prefer Dictate over Furnace of Wrath, due to Dictate's ability to act as a huge combat trick with its flash. It's important to run removal, even when playing a deck where you don't want to remove most things. Our spot removal cards are Seal of Removal, Seal of Cleansing, Break Ties, Generous Gift, and Oblation. These aren't super plentiful, so only use them on things you absolutely need to. For our board wipes, we're running Single Combat, Promise of Loyalty, Austere Command, and Dismantling Wave, which is actually a targeted removal spell, but can board wipe enchantments and artifacts if you cycle it. Notably, that cycling can be done at instant speed, making it super useful, if expensive.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful, and since we've no place to go, let us know.
Most of our card advantage is going to come from Zedru herself, and we have some in our defense cards as well, but that's no reason to not run some more. First up, we have Pendant of Prosperity, which may or may not draw you cards, but does give itself away, which is something that Zedru likes. We're also running the powerful with Politics, Fact or Fiction, and Epiphany at the Drownyard. We've got massive artifact reanimation as well in Wake the Past and Triumphant Reckoning. And finally, we have a card that isn't actually card advantage, but does give us whatever card we desperately need, Long-Term Plans. It's not perfect, as it puts the card 3 deep into your library, but with Zedru, we should be drawing roughly that deep each turn anyway. Cast this at someone's end step, and draw the card during your next upkeep. I just want to mention a couple of upgrades and alternatives for the deck at this time, which you can add if you choose to. Among equipment cards, the swords are awesome. Just make sure you avoid protection from blue and white. Our targeted removal is all blue and white. Battle Mage's Bracers and Illusionist Bracers let you give 2 things away with Zedru at once. That could be useful if you add more gifts to the deck than I have. Finally, a fun way to win would be through cards like Mob Rule and Insurrection, just stealing the creatures that all of the equipments are attached to and swinging out. Alright, we've made it through 95 cards in this deck and an upgrade section. And you're probably asking yourself, okay, but how does it win? Well, my friend, worry not. I haven't forgotten to add a win condition into the deck. That'd be a classic group hug failure. Instead, I've saved them all for the segment that I call
The Final Countdown!
Sleigh bells ring, are you listening?
At number 5, we don't actually have a win condition, but instead a second copy of Zedru, or as close to a second copy as I could find anyway. That card is Bazaar Trader. It costs less to cast and gift with than Zedru, but needs to tap to activate and doesn't draw you extra cards or gain you extra life. Overall, I think that's a fair trade-off. Now at number 4, we move on to our first win condition card. This one is Pure Steel Paladin. This is a fantastic card and does very well in equipment decks. That said, we're probably not going to want to put it on the battlefield until we have two other pieces ready to go. First, we need a board wipe like Austere Command so we can destroy all artifacts. Then we need a card like Wake the Past to put them all on the battlefield. Pure Steel Paladin will simultaneously fill our hand with fuel and be able to equip all of them for 0 mana, either to itself or to Zedru. Now just swing in for massive damage. Our number 3 card has a similar game plan to Pure Steel Paladin, but less setup to make it work, which puts it higher on our list. This card is Mantle of the Ancients. Simply board wipe the artifacts, and then cast Mantle on Zedru. Ever wonder what Santa would be like if he decided to just keep all of the BB guns for himself, and then got angry? Well, you're about to find out. At number 2, we have Fumble. Oh no, you're swinging at me with your giant creature, I guess I'm gonna lose. Gotcha! Seriously, the most fun part of this is that those equipment can, but don't have to be, attached to your own creature. I wonder what we could do with that knowledge. And that brings us to number 1. Fumble may be an instant and only costs 2 mana, but it does require you to give all of your equipment to one player and for them to equip all of it to one creature. But for 5 mana? Well, for 5 mana you can cast our all-in-one win condition card, Volshock Battlemaster. It's going to attach all equipment to itself, including equipment you don't own. It's got haste, and it's coming to burn down your opponent's village. Ladies, lock up your husbands, because this woman is going to paint the town red with their blood. Well, that's the whole deck. Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to the channel for more deck techs. A special thanks to my patrons over at Patreon. You guys and gals rock. And so Santalope was there to say, Merry Christmas, in her sleigh. As she rode to a great height, she spoke once more, and good night.